6 days from now, two National Guardsmen from Maine will begin a grueling mission. Colonel Jack Mosher of Waterville and Major Herbert Brock of Winslow plan to run the entire 550 miles between Kittery, Maine and Washington, D.C.'s Arlington National Cemetery. They'll begin next Saturday morning. Combined, they will run a marathon 26.2 miles each day for 21 straight days. As News 8's Steve Minich tells us, it's all about teaching their fellow soldiers a lesson in resiliency.
Many of our veterans that are returning are facing problems of depression, addiction, anxiety.
They're some of the same problems Jack Mosher and Jay Brock say they faced when they returned home from fighting overseas. Problems they eventually helped conquer through physical fitness.
Coming stronger through running, through a good diet, and through fitness made me a much more resilient person than I was when I got back. It was almost a daily prayerful activity that allowed me to overcome the adversity that I was facing in my own life at that time.
Today, both men continue working full-time for the National Guard. Both now avid runners. They say it's not just their bodies, but with exercise, their lives are healthier too. And that's the message they hope to spread, and the motivation that keeps them training mile after mile.
Yeah, certainly it is fun. As we're running along and thinking about the cause and why we're doing it, that helps move you along and keep you running through each day.
Now, each day, both of these guys will run 13.1 miles. Together, that 26.2 miles equals a marathon. But in this case, the marathon isn't just some arbitrary number. It's a metaphor for the sort of life soldiers lead every day.
The marathon has been a long-standing iconic symbol of endurance and resiliency and perseverance. We want to draw attention to the fact that many of our veterans face an emotional or psychological, or in some cases a physical marathon every day they wake up.
Along the way, Mosher and Brock will visit nearly a dozen veteran centers, touting the many programs returning vets have to help them through the difficult times.
We want to make sure that they, when necessary, reach out for the services that are available to them and take advantage of those programs to be well people, to be good fathers and good mothers through fitness and wellness.
Both acknowledge this will be a grueling and challenging effort. But as painful as those final few miles might be over 21 straight days, they're nothing, they say, compared to what so many of their fellow veterans endure every day.
So I think about my friends that I've lost. I've thought about the people that are at Walter Reed Medical Center right now, the guys that are sitting at home in their living rooms suffering unnecessarily because they're not willing to go out and ask for the help that they need.
What I'll be thinking about for the last few miles of each day is soldiers that are overseas right now, deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan, and the soldiers who have given their lives or have been wounded in action and aren't able to take on a run like this.
In Waterville, Steve Minich, News 8.
Now, if you'd like to help send the men on their way, Colonel Mosher, Major Brock will begin their run from Kittery Square coming up this Saturday morning, May 8th. They plan to leave at 8 o'clock sharp. If you want to track their progress over the three-week run or even join them for a leg, you can log on to the As Seen On section of our website, WMTW.com. Good luck to them.